Network X contains many types of random graph generators, but in addition, it also contains a few empirical datasets. Let's use one of them, called the Karate Club graph. In this network, the nodes represent members of a karate club, and the edges correspond to friendships between the members. We can extract the karate club data by typing karate club graph, and we can assign that network to object G. Network X is not really made for drawing networks, but we can nevertheless use it to produce some basic network visualizations. We first need to import matplotlib pyplot as plt. We can now use the nxdraw function to visualize our network. In this case, I'm going to use a couple of additional keyword arguments. First, I would like to have the labels visible inside the nodes. To do this, I use the withLabels keyword, and I set that to be equal to true. I can also set the node colors and edge colors to be whatever I would like. In this case, I'm going to set the node color to be equal to light blue, and I'm going to set the edge color to be equal to gray. Let's try saving this visualization into a PDF file. We can take the lines that we had before, and we use the plt savefig function. I'm going to call this cartograph.pdf, and then we can run the code. Let's then look for that file on the computer. We can make this a little bit bigger. And in this case, we have a visualization of the Karate Club network. Network X stores the degrees of nodes in a dictionary where the keys are node IDs and the values are their associated degrees. We can get access to that dictionary using the g.degree method. Again, the keys in the dictionary are node IDs, and the values are the corresponding degrees of the nodes. So for example, node 31 has 6 friends or 6 ties, node number 30 has 4, and so on. We can use this dictionary to find the degree of a given node, or alternatively, we can use the g.degree function. Let's try that out. g.degree gives us the dictionary, which is accessed by keys. So we can see from the above that we have a node called 33, and in this case, we know that the degree of that node is 17. Alternatively, we can use the g.degree method, and in this case, the argument is the node whose degree we would like to find out. And again, we get the same answer. Note that although both are called degree, Python distinguishes between the two based on their call signature. The former has no arguments, whereas the latter has one argument, the ID of the node whose degree we are querying. This is how Python knows whether to return a dictionary or whether to use a function to look up the degree of the given node.